This
Am I
conference
correct?
will now be recorded.
Okay, so till 99 only we are having two digit numbers. After 99 we are moving to third digit number, which is 100. Again after that 101, like that. So what I mean to say is, whenever you are having the digits, whether it is one digit or two digit or three digit, each digit have to be considered in four what is that? A code amma nu cheppindi 8642 code, something code you told, no? So in that four digit numbers we have to consider. Okay, so binary BCD equivalent of decimal number 10 is or else 20 you consider. Binary, I mean BCD representation of 20. 20 means 2 separate, 0 separate. For 2, what is BCD equivalent? It is 0010. Is this clear? So that you have to write aside. Again for 0, what is the BCD equivalent? All 4 zeros, something like that. Clear? So what is the binary equivalent of 20? Sorry, BCD value of 20 is 0010 and 0000. Suppose if I tell 21, what is the decimal equivalent? I mean binary coded decimal equivalent of 21 number is 22 and 1. For 2, BCD equivalent is 0010, and for 1,
0001.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Ardhamayinda. Is everyone clear with this? See, I'll explain once again. From decimal number from 0 to 9, okay, we have to convert this decimal number into BCD. Like if you're considering 9, decimal equivalent of 9, I mean, sorry. 9 is a decimal number system that we have to consider in BCD. What is BCD? Is binary coded decimal. Ante, we have to represent in decimal only with the binary codes. With the binary codes. What is binary codes? 0 and 1. 0 and 1 is our binary code. Clear? So, code 9, BCD equivalent of 9 is 1001. Am I correct?
See.
So, you have. Okay, 1001. Intavariki ardhamaindi kada. Ippudu cheppandi, what is the binary equivalent of BCD of 91? Suppose 91. 9, you know, 9 answer is 1001. And what is BCD equivalent of 91? So 9 you have to consider separate. For 9, you'll be getting 4 digits answer. Okay. For 1, you will be getting 4 digits. So what is the binary BCD equivalent of 91, guys?
1001 0001 1001 and 0001.
Okay, so suppose 99, what is BCD of 99?
1001 1001 1001.
Yeah, okay, so whatever the digits are there, you have to consider the individual digit. Okay, you have to consider the individual digit. You put them in the same way. This is about the two digit numbers. Till now we have seen about two digit numbers. Now you tell me three digit. How to convert a decimal, a three digit decimal number into BCD? Consider 248. The number 2, 4 and 8. 248. Give me the answer. 2, 4 and 8. So 2 BCD value you have to write down, 4 BCD value you have to write down, and 8 value you have to write down.
0010 0100 1010.
Very good. That means for BCD value of 2 you have to consider, which is 0010. Again BCD value of 4 you have to consider, 0100. Again you have to consider the BCD value of 8, which is 1000. So clear?
Zero.
So like this, how many number of digits are there? Those many number of BCD numbers you have to consider. So how you'll be writing the answer, the answer is always a combination of 0 to 9 letters. So if you know the BCD value of 0 to 9 decimal numbers, so you can build n number of BCD codes. Am I correct? So it's like that. Okay, so in the same way, we are having a BCD equivalence to binary decimal numbers from 0 to 9. Okay, so in the same way, we have BCD code for characters also. What that is called as alphanumeric representations. What is alphanumeric representation? Alpha means alphabet sets. Numeric means numbers. So alphanumeric we will call. So we will represent this alphanumeric representation in ASCII formats. What is ASCII? ASCII. What is the full form of ASCII? What is the full form of ASCII? Under C language passing in
Rada.
Forgot.
American Standard Coded for Information Interchange.
Very good, very good. It's American Standard Code for Information Interchange. That means this organization has given us the values, conversions. Clear? They have set some standards. Like for character A, for small letters, we are having separate binary code. For alphabets, we have, I mean, for capital letters, we are having separate code. For special symbols, we are having separate code and all that. Okay. So whenever I'm giving the notes, in that I will give the binary code of capital A, binary code of capital B. These are all prefixed. Okay. This ASCII has already fixed the value of these alphabets, numbers, special symbols and all that. So that we have represented in a table. So that I'll be sharing. Now I cannot share because I'm not using my GoToMeeting. I'm using Sirsha Madam. So I cannot share you, I think. The screen as the organizer. Okay. So that is the reason I'm not sharing. So tomorrow I'll share, or else while giving the notes after two topics, first unit will be finished. Then in that unit, first unit notes, I'll be sharing this. Clear? So this ASCII has set the standards. Each character uses 7-digit codes. Okay, 7-digit code to 128 characters. So how many characters are there like that? 128 characters are there. So in this 128 characters, all the small letters, capital letters, the special symbols, the digits, everything is included, including the space. Whatever space we are giving in between the input values, that space also will be converted. Clear? For space symbol, for all the special symbols, for characters from 0 to 9 numbers, capital letters, small letters, everything, all 128 characters are there. Clear? So the binary code for uppercase letters, the decimal digits, special characters, for everything they have given the binary code. Clear? So this is about the alphanumeric representation. And also in the alphanumeric representation is there under decimal representation only. Under decimal representation, BCD is there. What is BCD? BCD is binary coded decimal. Clear? Coming to second type of number system, which is called as binary number system. Okay. So you know, what is the binary number system? See, for example, I'm giving 135. 135 to the base 10, I'm giving you. Again, 135 to the base 8, I am giving. 135 to the base 16, I am giving. So, if you see, all the inputs are same. 135, 135, 135. The number is same. But it is in which number system that matters, actually. So, how you'll recognize the number? The number is in which number system? By considering the base. So, if the base is 10, then that is in the decimal number system. If the base is 8, what is the number system which represents, which takes the base 8? Base 8. What is the number system?
Octal. Octal, ma'am.
Octal. Base 16?
Hexa.
Hexa. Hexa decimal, we will call it as. Hexa's decimal. Clear? So, 135 to the base 10 is decimal, 135 to the base 8 is octal, 135 to the base 16 is decimal. Clear? So this is about the number system. So coming to second one, what is that we have discussed? We are in the middle, binary. So binary number system, binary means two. Two means how many digits? Two digits are there, which is 0 and 1. So if you are giving to the base 2, then it is called as binary number system. So 5 to the base 2, I wanted to give 5 to the base 2. That means I have to convert 5 number to binary number. So convert 5 number 5 to binary number. What is the answer? Convert number 5 to binary.
Zero triple one.
So simply what you will do, you will divide it by 2, you will consider the numerator, you will consider the, what is that? Entity? Reminder. Reminder is either 0 or 1. Like that you'll consider. See, suppose I forgot one point in decimal number system, then I'll come back to binary. See, suppose if I'm giving 724, okay, convert 724, how you'll represent that decimal number, how to convert it? Na question ardhamainda anukunta kada. For example, in decimal number systems, 724 ni convert cheyamantunna. How you will consider? Ippudu binary kaithe 2 to the power of 0, 2 to the power of 1 and we will consider in the 2 to the power. But whereas this decimal, what is the radix you will consider? What is the radix number system? What is the radix number we have to use for decimal? It is 10. Okay, 724 ante eman pedtaru 724, three digits unnai kada, so always it will start from 0. So 4 into 10 to the power of 1, before that plus petti 2 into 10 to the power of 1, again plus 7 into 10 to the power of 2. How many numbers are there? Three numbers are there, three digits are there. So always you consider 3 and 0 to 2. So 7 into 10 to the power of 2 plus 2 into 10 to the power of 1 plus 4 into 10 to the power of 0. Is it clear, everyone? Respond. 724 means 3 digits. We have to consider 3 digits. So 3 digits as it is in decimal number system. Deci means 10. 3 ante 0 ninchi 2. Okay, so first number em undi 7 undi. So any digits unnai 3 unnai ante minus 1, 0 nunchi start avutundi kabatti n minus 1 consider cheyali. So 7 into 10 to the power of 2 plus, because each digit we will separate by using plus symbol, plus 2 into 10 to the power of 1 plus 4 into 10 to the power of 0. Clear? Like this we have to do. Like this we have to do for a integer number like 724. Suppose the same thing if I am giving a float number like 724.5, I am giving, how you will consider? I am giving 0.5. so how you will consider? I think my question is clear. I think 724.5, convert this. It is decimal. Manam convert jayal. If you are having point, after point, if you are having one digit, what is the radix?
10 to the power minus 1.
Very good. 10 to the power of minus 1. 5 into plus
1.
10 to the power of minus 1. Suppose two digits are there. 724.52. Suppose after point you are having two digits. 724.52.
5 into 10 to the power minus 1 plus 2 into 10 to the power minus 2.
Minus 2. That means before left side of the point is always the power will start from 0. Okay, and right side of the point, always the point will start from the minus 1. So in a short, our powers are ranging from 0 to plus, here plus 1, 2, 3, 4, and again from here 0 to minus 1, 2, 3, 4, based on the digits. Like how many digits are there after 0, then we are considering that 0, 1, 2, 3. Again, after the point, we have to consider minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on. Yes, so is everyone is clear, I think. This is an example under decimal. The same thing is will be applicable when we are giving the same number in octal also. In octal, I am giving the same number 724.5 or 724 in octal. How you'll consider the same thing? Instead of 10, you will consider radix as number 8. Okay. Base ni మనం ఏమంటాం, దాని ఏమంటాం రాడిక్స్ అంటాం కదా, పవర్ ని ఐ మీన్ పైన ఉండేది పవర్ అంటాం, కింద దాన్ని రాడిక్స్ అంటాం. ఓకే, సో 724 ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంట్ టు రిప్రజెంట్ ఇన్ ఆక్టల్, ఆక్టల్ అంటే 8. సో గుర్తు పెట్టుకోండి, 8 అంటే ఎన్ని డిజిట్స్ ఉంటాయి, ఫ్రమ్ 0 టు 7 ఓన్లీ. ఆల్వేస్ దట్ వాల్యూ విల్ రేంజెస్ ఫ్రమ్ 0 టు 7. 8 విల్ నాట్ బి దేర్ ఇన్సైడ్ ఇట్, 9 విల్ నాట్ బి దేర్ ఇన్సైడ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ ద ఆక్టల్. దట్ యు రిమెంబర్. How many digits will be there? Only from 0 to 7 it will be there. So the same number 724, if I wanted to represent in the octal, so simply instead of 10 I will replace by 8. So yes, I'll write it as 7 into 8 to the power of 2 plus 2 into 8 to the power of 2 plus 4 into 8 to the power of 0. Here, instead of 10, simply will represent 8. And the same number, if I'm giving 724.5 to the base 8, okay, 724.5 to the base 8. So what I will do? 724.5 to the base 8. So what will be the answer? 0.5, point tarvata em undi? 5 undi. So I will add plus symbol. I'll keep 5 into 8 to the power of minus 1.
Right. 1.
Yeah, same thing. The same example I'm considering. In decimal number system, we have to represent it by 10. In the octal, we have to represent it by 8 when we are giving the points. This is the same thing. Coming to the hexadecimal. Hexa means how many? Hexa means actually hexadecimal, 10 plus 6, 16 are there. So the radix will be, the symbol will, the radix number, what is the radix number for hexadecimal is 16 are there. So how the 16 will be considered is, this radix actually, this is very important in digital computer work actually. When we are dealing with the digital computer work, this hexadecimal number is very important. So the 8 symbols of the octal, this octal numbers are 7. The 16 symbols of this hexadecimals are from 0 to 9. How many finish? 0 to 9 means 10. 0 to 9 means 10. The number 10 will be represented by small a. Number 11 will be represented by, not small a, capital A. Number 11 will be represented by capital B. 12 is capital C. 13 is capital D. 14 is capital E. And 15 is capital F. Clear? So from 0 to F we have to consider here. So the last 6 symbols are from A to F we have to consider. Clear? You don't confuse. From A to F we have to consider. Okay. So when we are using this representation of hexadecimal, the symbols A to F that will be correspond to numbers 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So till representing, so always it is starting from 0 to 15. So 0 to 15 means how many digits we are considering? 16 digits we are considering. Clear? So how to convert F3? Suppose I'm giving F3. F3 and the popular synonym F2 uses them. F2. Okay. Convert this F2 into this decimal. How you'll convert F2 to the base 16 I am giving. Okay, if you're having a pen and paper, please give me the answer. Or else F3 you consider. F3, what is the answer? F3, when we are converting the decimal equivalent of hexadecimal F3 is, what is the answer? How to convert it? Convert and tell me. F3. So F3 and how many digits are there? Two digits are there. So F means, what is the hexadecimal equivalent of F is?
15.
Because F is the last symbol, right? F last number. So F is the last number. So F we will represent it by 15. So in place of F, you have to write 15. So 15 into 16 to the power of 1 plus 1. Into 16 to the power of
0.
0.
So what is the answer? 15 into 16 plus 3. What is the answer?
243.
Very good. 15, 16 is 240 plus 3 is 243. So the decimal equivalent of hexadecimal F3 is 243. Clear? So like this, whatever the number we are giving, we have to consider the thing. Same thing will be happened with the point also. If you know, suppose F3 point to each and F3 point to each, how you'll consider F3 point two. So after point two, you'll keep plus 2 into, 16 to the power of minus 1. Okay. So till now we have this, I think in your previous subjects or years, you are considered only the whole numbers, I think. You did not done with your points, I think, decimals. Okay. So whenever decimal points are there, how many number of digits are there? Those many number of minus ones we have to increase. So minus 1, again minus 2, again minus 3, something like that we have to do. Clear? So this is about the number systems. What and all we have discussed? Hexadecimal, binary. Ekaduna. My go-to meeting poinda. 1 minute, I can't. Yeah, I'm here only. Yeah. So till now we have discussed about binary number system, hexadecimal number system, and octal number system and decimal number system. Okay, so these four are the main important four decimal numbers, number systems. This number system comes under data representation only. Okay, so this is called fixed point representation, floating point representation, and amanmanta. Fixed point representation ante, like if you are having only numbers like 245, it is fixed. 245.5 means floating point. So how we represent the floating points in the decimal number system and all that we have seen in this today's class. Clear? Anyone is having any doubts? If you're having any doubts, please unmute yourself. You can tell you people you want break means take 5 minutes break and next class will be continued by madam. So anyone is having doubts, you can unmute yourself and answer me that, ask, you can ask. And the same thing I'm repeating, guys, if you are listening your class by using any mobile, desktop or laptop, please forward me the screenshot of the attendance. Respond, please. Who is this A? Who is this caller 8? Who is these two persons? The attendance list A is there, caller 8 is there. So attendance will not be considered for these two persons. A and caller 8. Still people are, they are not feeding their names with the rule number and section. So who is taking the attendance? Who has logged the go-to meeting from desktop or laptop? Who has taken the attendance? Shall I forward a sample attendance screenshot? No, I cannot share, I think. I cannot share today because I did not start the meeting. I cannot share. Okay. So Risha madam only shared. No. No one is listening the class from laptop or desktop? Oh.
Ma'am, I took the screenshot and I'll share it to you, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. So as soon as you're sharing, your number will not be there in that. So type the number also.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, two persons have shared. Thank you so much. One is Sai Kumar has forwarded, and one more person is Shreyansh. Two persons I have forwarded. Thank you so much, guys. So I think no one is having doubts regarding this number system class today. So your people are clear with my class, right? So if you people are clear with the class, then I will sign out from this. Because please students, don't go from this go to meeting. You take a break of 5 minutes. Your madam will start the class at 11:10. You still be there in this app only, because she will continue the class in the same link. Okay, madam will continue the class in the same link, you just go for break for till 11:10. Okay, 11:10 वरकी break తీసుకోండి. Till 11:10 you take the break and continue the class. Don't log out from this link. Okay, I'll be logging out. Okay na bye. Meer log avvakandi malli madam ki malli raadu. Okay.
Good morning, ma. So you take no, 5 minutes only. 5 minutes is left. Okay, you take the break and I will start by 11:10. Okay.
This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, see here. If we come to the threats and all, I told you already what is meant by threats. It is nothing but a cybersecurity threat, which is malicious and which will damage and which will steal our data. That is nothing but a threat here. So how many types of threats are there? I told you already that computer viruses will be there, and as well as data breaches will be there, and DOS attacks will be there. Denial of service attacks. So anything which will take the advantage of the weakness of your system is nothing but a threat, and which will harm your data, which will steal your data, so which is of very sensitive, that is called as a threat. So how many types of threats are there? Software attacks are there. So what are the software attacks here? It can be, these are the things which can be attacked by the viruses, worms, and as well as Trojan horses. Okay, so many users, they will think that all these things are same, but all these things are not same here. Malware is different, and as well as again, this malware, it is divided into two categories, that is the infection methods and as well as the malware actions. So what are these infection methods? Means these are trying to infect into our system. Okay, so if we take the virus, already I told you about that virus. What is that virus? It is nothing but they will be having the capacity to replicate the copy of files by themselves. to replicate the copy of files by themselves. So such type of thing which will be replicating in our system, and it will slow down our system's performance also. Okay, that is called as virus. That is the thing which will be done by the virus. Then what about the worms here? So worms, what is the task of the worms? Means it will not replicate here, but the only thing is these are all network aware. That means they will be traveling throughout the each and every system, each and every computer which is on the network. Okay, but it will not do much harm. The only thing is it will completely consume all your hard disk space and all. Okay, so that is called as worms. Okay, that is the work done by the worms. It will consume your hard disk space, and so once it is consuming, means what happens? Automatically your system will get slow down and you can't work properly with your things. Okay, and it will slow down, and there may be a chance that your system will get damage also. Okay, and next one is the Trojans. So what is the Trojans here? Completely I told you one story about the Trojans, which is there in your, when you studied your English things and all, you can find out what is the Trojan. So in that particular big wooden horse, they will be hiding their soldiers, and with the help of their soldiers they will be attacking the different regions and all. Okay, so in the same way here also, your virus will be hided somewhere and it will tries to steal your information. Okay, that is the work done by the Trojan here. And the next one is the bots. What are these bots? Means these are some of the advanced form of the worms. Okay, so bots means nothing but they will automate all your processes and all, and they will, without any human interaction, they will try to infect one host, and after infecting again, they will create the connection with the central servers. They will create the connections with the central servers, and it will provide all the commands to all the infected hosts which are attached to that particular network. So that is called as botnets. Here we are not clicking any link also. So everything will be done automatically. All the things will be done automatically, and all the malicious things will be infected through one host, which is on the network. Okay, and it will be connected to one central server. So whatever the commands that which they are executing, all that commands it will be executing in all the hosts which are infected, which are already infected. So that particular thing is called as botnet. That is called as botnet. Okay, and some of the actions of the malware we will see. What is that? Adware, spyware, and ransomware. Okay, I think we have stuck here. And what is that adware? I told you already, some of the ads will be popping in your system, right? So you will automatically, if you are attracted, means what you will do, you will just click that particular link. So if you are clicking that link, means what will happen, sir? The thing which is malicious, it will directly install in your system, and it will do whatever the things it wants. Okay, nicely it will be entered into your system, and it will compromise all the things. So whatever the activities are there, all the system activities they will perform. See here. So that is the thing which will be done by the adware. So they will display the ads on your computer desktop, or individual inside programs will be there. Okay, they will monitor your interest. Okay, someone is fond of some job related things. So someone is fond of learning things. So that means learning some new programming languages like that. So like that, based upon our interest, some ads will be displayed. So if you are trying to click any of that link, means automatically it will embed the malicious code inside the software. So adware, it will monitor, it will sit silently in your system, and it will monitor all your system activities and all, and it will compromise your machines also. So those are the actions which will be done by the malware. Okay, and next one is spyware. What is this spyware here? So spyware means what it will do, means we can say it, this one also as a software, it will monitor your activities on the computer and reveals the collected information to some parties, again to some third parties. Okay, that is the thing which will be done by the spyware, just like a spy. Okay, in the olden days we will be having some informers will be there, right? They will be collecting all the information and they will be giving to the PS and all. So in the same way here, this spyware also, it will sit silently in your system, it will monitor all the things, and that will be giving all the collected information to some interested third parties, right? So in the same way, and one more example they have given for the spyware is the keylogger. Keylogger is the very most important one here. That means already I told you that whatever the things that is written or whatever the things that is typed by user, all that keystrokes will be tracked. And if you are trying to type any of your usernames and passwords or credit card details, means all that things also will be catch hold by these keyloggers. Keyloggers is also dangerous. This is also one type of spyware. Okay. And the next one is the ransomware. What is that ransom? Can anyone tell me about that ransom? What is that ransom? So ransomware, this is also one type of malware where it will encrypt all your files or it will lock your computers. Okay, it will lock your computers and it will make it inaccessible. That means our system, it will be locked by some other person and they will be asking some money again in order to unlock your system back. Okay, that means in exchange they are trying to ask some money for that, to unlock all your documents or any confidential files. That is called as ransomware. Ransom, the name itself indicates that they are trying to charge some money for unlocking all your documents. That is called as ransomware. Is it clear, ma? Next one is scareware. So what is it? Scareware means it is nothing but one tool which will help to fix your system. But when the software is executed, it will infect your system or it will completely destroy it. Okay. It will displace the message to frighten you, or it will force to take some action like paying them or to fix your system. So what is nothing but in one simple line, I can say you that scareware is nothing but a simple software which will be executed and it will destroy our system completely, or it will infect our system. Okay, so that is called as scareware. Okay, and next one is the rootkits. What is this rootkits here means? Rootkits are nothing but they will gain all the administrative privileges of your system, and once after gaining all the root access privileges and all, they will be stealing all the private files from your system. That is called as rootkit. Okay, and next one is the zombies. What are these zombies here? So zombies are nothing but they will work similarly to the spyware. Okay, they will work similarly to the spyware. I told you already about the spyware. It will sit silently and it will monitor all the activities, and they will be informing to some intelligent third party people, right? In the same way here also it will work, but the thing is infection mechanism is same, but they don't spy and steal the information. Okay, they will not spy and they will, it's not stealing any information. They are trying to wait for the command from the hackers. Okay, so once if the hackers say okay, then they will, based upon the commands that is given by the hackers, they do proceed. Okay, so that is the work done by the zombies. That is the work done by the zombies. Okay, and next one is the theft of intellectual property. Theft of intellectual property means, I told you already that intellectual property rights, just like copyrights and patent rights, will be given to each and every individual person. Suppose if I have discovered anything, or you have discovered something, okay, which is useful for the society, you will be the main copyright person and you will be the main, that means you can file a patent with your name also. So all that particular rights will be there with your name. So sometimes these are the people, they will try to steal that type of intellectual information also. That is called as theft of intellectual property. Okay, so identity, that means they do act like I have discovered all these things, this is my patent and these are the things which are of my copyrights. Okay, no one should copy these things. Like that, they will try to manage that they have discovered your things. Okay, that is called as theft of intellectual property. Next one, identity theft. Already I told you in the first class itself about the identity theft. So identity theft means nothing but stealing the individual person's information, personal information, like your Aadhaar card or your certificates or anything. Suppose if you are trying to submit any of your details in any consultancy or like that, by changing their name, their address and phone number and your photo also, they will try to create some fake documents and they can apply in some bank accounts for the loans or like that also. That is called as identity theft. I am stealing your identity. Okay, I am stealing your name. all the information related to your certificates I am stealing, and I will be acting as a genuine person. That is called as identity theft. And one more thing is theft of equipment and information. Theft of equipment and information. What is the theft of equipment and information means here? Nowadays, the increasing nature of mobile devices, it has been increased here. Okay. So here, sometimes there may be a chance that your mobile devices can be stealed, or they will try to unlock all the information which is there in your mobiles also. So that is the reason you need to protect your mobile devices also. With some passwords, pin numbers. I think everybody knows how to keep that pin numbers, patterns, locks, whether it can be the fingerprint or the facial recognition. Okay. Like that, they will try to protect your devices. And one more thing is sabotage. What is that sabotage here? Sabotage means nothing but completely destroying a company's website. Completely destroying the complete company's website. That is nothing but sabotage. Okay, so previously many big companies, that means universities, websites are also hacked. Why they have been hacked? Due to less security measures, they have been hacked. So that is the reason we should protect it completely so that no one should hack your website. Okay, so previously many of the JNTH related websites or Delhi University websites also hacked. That is called as a sabotage. Okay, they want to release, they have released all the user IDs. Okay, users, names, passwords, everything native has been released. Such a type of case studies are also there. Okay, and next one is a sabotage. Sabotage is completed. Next one is the information extortion. So what is meant by information extortion here? Information extortion, it is nothing but the theft of company's property or information to receive payment in exchange. Okay, so I am trying to steal my company's property or information. Okay, what I should get in return, I should get some payment in exchange. Okay, it is a little bit like ransomware, but the thing is there I am going to lock all my victims' files and documents. But the here the thing is a little bit different. That is, I am trying to steal my company's property or related information. I am not locking here, just I have stealed all that information. So in return, I am asking them to pay some amount. Okay, that is called as information extortion. Information extortion. Okay, so all these things are nothing but these are some type of attacks which can be done if we are having less security measures. Okay, so in addition to that, apart from these, many other threats are also there. So what are those threats means? Technology with weak security. Okay. Suppose if I am going to use technology, right now many different types of electronic gadgets are being released in the market, right? So if I am going to use a fully secured devices, means it well and good. That means it has to follow all the cyber security principles and laws and regulations. Then no problem. But if any weak security things if you are going to use, means there may be a chance that theft of data or information can be done within your devices. Okay. And next one is the social media attacks. Social media attacks, I think everyone aware of the social media attacks. What is that social media attacks? Social media attacks. Are you there? Satya Varun. Anyone? What is meant by social media attacks? You can unmute and you can speak.
Attacking any personal accounts, like.
Attacking the personal accounts.
Using fake
yes,
accounts.
Ma'am.
That means by using the social media networking sites, okay, they will try to scan all our profiles and they will try to go to our contact list and if any confidential information or such type of things are there, means they will try to steal such type of information. Okay, it can be related to organization or it can be related to the companies or any other things. Okay, or individually, if they are trying to target one individual person also, such type of things also may happen. All the things which are related, all the type of attacks which are related to these social media networking sites, all this will comes under social media attacks, right? And next one is the mobile malware. What is that mobile malware here? Mobile malware means, see here, there will be a connectivity to the internet, right? Each and every mobile nowadays, without connecting to the internet, they are not doing a single thing also, right? So if we start our day, means our day will start with mobiles, right? So we will start with some green button. What is that green button? WhatsApp. Okay, we will start with some blue color button, that is called as Facebook. So these are the major things which we will follow daily. Okay, so that is called as mobile malware. Mobile malware means whenever you are trying to interconnect, means automatically if any malicious things are there, or if you are trying to download anything, you don't know, but if you want to play the games like PUBG or any other games, unintentionally you will download the things, but you don't know that some malware is installed in your system automatically. So it will monitor all the things and it will try to steal all the personal information. Okay, so all your malwares and viruses will be installed in your devices. So better, whatever the games which are there in the Play Store, don't try to download all the games. Okay, so there will be some of the infected and malware apps also will be there, so which will be harm to your mobiles. Okay, the things is, now everybody is trying to focus on your mobile devices. If they are trying to hack your mobiles, means all the information they will get. So better you protect your mobile devices also with some antivirus software. Antivirus softwares and antivirus apps also will be there. Better you install and you keep protected your devices. Okay, and outdated software, security software. Suppose if you are trying to use any of the outdated security softwares, means so once after installing, again from time to time we need to update it. So if you are using any of the outdated, means again we are giving a chance to new threats and new vulnerabilities. That's it. And next one, corporate data on personal devices. Corporate data on personal devices, this is also one of the thing where we are give a chance to hack our things. Okay, see, these days each and every organization, they are going to follow the rule as BIOD. So BIOD means bring your own device. Bring your own device. Bring your own device means any software organization, they will be instructing the their staff to bring their own laptops, and all the data related to the company will be there in that particular laptops. So whenever they are carrying to their homes or some other places, automatically what may then some type of security threats and security related issues they will get. So what, why they are doing like that, means not all the companies, they can't provide each and every laptop to all the staff members, right? So in such cases, they will insist the faculty to do like that. So this is also one of the dangerous thing where we can giving a chance to steal our information, or giving a chance for the threats and as well as security related things. Okay, and next one is the social engineering. Okay, what is that social engineering? It is nothing but manipulating the people. If I am manipulating the people, means they will give all their confidential information and all. Okay, so the criminals, they will trick you into giving your private and confidential information. Okay, and once if I am getting a trust, means I will give the access to access my computer, and whenever they are giving, I am giving any access, means nicely they will install the malicious software into my computer and they will get all the control of my computer. Okay, suppose, see, one example they gave it here about the social engineering. One of my friend is there. Okay, so social engineering means I told you that all my friends details and their information, everything will be there. Okay, you got a mail, okay, that particular mail is already infected with some virus. If you are trying to download any links or attachments of that particular email thinking that you got from your friend, so no issues. Usually we will think like that, like, is it true or not? So if we are getting any mails from our friends, means we will treat it as this is genuine and we will try to download the things, but it is already infected. So how you got all your friends contact list and all, means again from the social media networks and all. Okay, so the nicely they will try to access your friend's device and contact list and all. So if you are trying to download any of the things, means again your system will be in the danger, right? So these, what are all these things, means nothing but, these are nothing but some other different types of threats which are there, new generation threats which are already available in the running days. Okay, so that is about the threats and all, what type of infections are there, what is a malware, okay, what is an infection, what is a virus, what is a worm, what is a Trojan horses, everything we have explained. So any doubt still, anyone? It's clear, no, till here? You can unmute and you can speak, ma. Banu, Soma Reddy, Akshaya, Divya, many are there, but no one is speaking. So if no doubts are there, means shall we go for the next topic, that is harmful acts. Okay, harmful acts is the next topic. We will see what is that harmful acts. Okay, generally this is the terminology they gave it to cover all the different types of cyber crimes. Okay, they have covered all the different types of cyber crimes. What are the different types of cyber crimes? So we have discussed all the cyber crimes in the first day itself. But still again I will explain you. So such type of, what are the things of those cyber crimes, means phishing is the major thing, and spoofing is there. Spoofing, I will explain you what is meant by that spoofing, and denial of service attacks will be there, or credit card frauds will be there, credit card frauds, online transaction frauds will be there, and cyber defamation, child pornographies, and kidnapping a person using some chat rooms and all. Okay, stalking a person using internet as a medium, and unauthorized access to your computer system, or cyber terrorism is also there. These are some of the harmful acts in the cyber security related things. Okay, so what we have to do, means to achieve all these goals of gaining access or disabling operations, they have given some different types of technical methods which have been deployed by the cyber criminals. Okay, what are the different types of things, operations they will be performed by the cyber criminals, means they have listed out all these things here, that is malware, phishing, ransomware, denial of service attack, man in the middle attack, cryptojacking, and SQL injection. All these are the different types of things which will be happening. Okay, and first we will see what is that malware. So already malware we know, okay, it is nothing but a malicious software which we are trying to install into our computer or a server, right? So what is the type of malware? It can be viruses, worms, or Trojan horses, botnets, okay, anything we can consider it as a malware here. Okay, and what are the types of attacks which may render your computer, so it will make our system as inoperable, okay, or it will grant the attacker all the admin right permissions, and they will try to control our system remotely. Okay, they will sit at some other place, but they will try to control our system. That is called as controlling the system remote, by sitting at some remote place. Okay, so this is called as malware. This is one type of operation performed by the cyber criminal. See, all of you please mute yourself. And the next one is the phishing, ma. What is that phishing means? Phishing is a technique which can be used by all the cyber criminals. They will be drafting all the emails. Okay, and suppose if I got the emails, means what I will be thinking, that I need to click that email. So unfortunately, without knowing any of all these things, if I am clicking that particular thing, means I will be in the danger. Why? Because if you are trying to download any malware means, definitely if any of the important documents and things are there means, all the things can be hacked. And one more thing is, if you are clicking anything means again, it will be redirecting to some fake websites. It will, for seeing, it will be just like the original one, but it's not like that. It is a fake website. Okay, so in that fake website, again, they will be asking you regarding some usernames and passwords and all. Okay, so what you will do automatically, thinking that this particular thing is a genuine website, and you will be providing all your usernames, your passwords, everything. Okay, so this is called as phishing. So many. Teaching faculty. Okay, so he has been redirected to some fake website. He don't know that it is a fake website, and unfortunately he has charged 18,000 rupees. Okay, so nowadays the central government also, they have released n number of websites. So all that websites, they are trying to create the fake websites also. So for seeing, if we don't know means it will be treating it as a original website, but it's not like that. Many fake websites are there, just like government related websites. They will be targeting all the central government or the, our government related websites only. Okay, that is the phishing concept. And one more thing is the ransomware. Already you know about the ransomware, right? So what is that ransomware? Nothing but charging some amount of money by encrypting all the victim details or victim documents and all. Yeah. So if you are trying to
Karakara.
Please everyone mute your microphones, ma. Okay. That is about the ransomware. We are giving the instructions and all. Suppose if you are trying
please
to
stop,
click
on this link.
You can pay the fees. You can pay the fees if you are trying to pay it.
Who is that location?
See, once make a call to him. Maybe he don't know. From 3A. And next one is the denial of service attack. What is the denial of service attack means? This is one type of thing where we are trying to stop some online services from working normally. Okay, that is called as denial of service attack. So attackers, they will send a lot of traffic to your website or many n number of requests to your database so that it will not function. Okay, so that is called as a denial of service attacks. So they will be trying to send more amount of So more amount of request we are going to get, and automatically your system will not function as a normal system. Such type of attacks are called as denial of service attacks. And one more thing is distributed denial of service attacks are also there. Distributed denial of service attacks. Okay, these mainly they have been targeted by some army of computers. Army of computers, which will be usually compromised by the malware, and under the control of all the things will be under the control of cyber criminals and all. Okay. Number someone from 3A, will you please inform him? Next one, come to this man in the middle attack. So what is this man in the middle attack means? It is nothing but this is also one type of attack where if we are trying to do any of the transaction, means what will happen? One user, he will try to secretly enter into that particular transaction and he will try to catch all our details and all. But here the thing is the attacker, they will try to set up one Wi-Fi network here. All that Wi-Fi network with the help of some login screens. Okay, they will be sitting and once if you are trying to enter any of your details like user details or any password details means they will try to attack by sitting in the middle. So we don't know that one person is monitoring in the middle. Okay, the such type of attacks are called as a man in the middle attack. And next one is the cryptojacking. So what is that cryptojacking means? This is also one type of specialized attacks are there where involve all the different types of computers and all for generating the cryptocurrencies. Okay, so what the attackers will do means they will install all the malware on the victim computers from all the different types of calculations and sometimes what they will do means they will just run the JavaScript which will execute in the victim's browser. Okay, that is called as cryptojacking. That is called as cryptojacking, generating the cryptocurrencies for you. So what the hackers will do means they will be trying to install the malware and they will try to do some necessary calculations, or else what they will do, there may be a chance that they can run some code in the JavaScript in the victim's browser. Okay, so that is called as cryptojacking. Next one, if you observe, see here SQL injection is there. So what is meant by SQL injection means with the help of some SQL structured query language commands and all, they will try to take all the to the SQL data. Sai Krishna 406. 406 or 3A. 3A people, will you please inform that location?
Yes, ma'am.
And one more thing is, please someone take the screenshot from your desktop. So where it should visible all the users list and all. Okay. So what is meant by SQL injection means it is nothing but the attacker, they will try to control the victim's database. Okay, how they will control the victim's database means they will try to obey all the commands which are written in the structured query language. Okay, so automatically what they will do means whatever the commands they are executing, they will be redirecting to the SQL databases. So such type of attacks are called as, that means they will try to grab your databases which are there in your website and all. Okay. Suppose if your website is very weak, means automatically this type of SQL injections may also happen with the help of these SQL injection attacks. Okay. And next one is the zero-day exploits. So what is the zero-day exploit means? These are nothing but vulnerabilities in the software. Okay. I told you already about the patch management. So what is that patch management? Each and every software, some flaws will be there.
Such flaws and all, we will be running some software where they will try to manage all these patches. Okay, in the same way, can be done with the help of these patches. And sometimes the government agencies, they will try controversially, they may use them for their
own hacking purposes also, okay, rather than releasing the information about them for their common benefit. Okay, this is about the harmful acts. That means these type of things which may done to each and every, that means all these things will be normally performed by the cyber criminals. Okay, so that is the thing we should be able to keep an eye while doing any online transactions or any of the transactions or any activities in your computers or in your mobile phones. So if you are aware of all this, automatically will control your things and all.
Neither up either.